Hi, Mark Rothfield from Club Marine TV, and today we're aboard something very special for those who like a little water sports mixed with some luxury and long-range cruising potential at a fraction of the price of a waterfront weekender. Her name is the Riviera 465 SUV, so come aboard. So let's start in the cockpit, which puts the sport in SUV. You'll be spending a lot of time out here. It's not overly long, about a bit over a metre, but it's really nice and wide. And things you notice is very clever features. The boarding gates, one each side, open flush. So that gets you this great access to the boarding platform. Really extends the cockpit, makes it huge. It's hydraulic in this case, that's an option. You can have it fenced off if you want to. So again, more cockpit space, great for bottom fishing if that's what you're into. You can have this covered by a Euro awning. Fantastic for our summer. Moving through, you've got a fridge, ice maker, fantastic wet bar with a barbecue. You have a docking station to port and really easy access to the bow. Moving forward, actually felt really nice and safe. The rails at a good thigh height, good wide side decks as well. Riv never misses an opportunity to create entertaining space. Here they've got this big sun pad with these back supports that can actually raise or lower if you want it as a full sunbed. No bowsprit again on this hull. It's all the anchoring is integrated into the lines of the boat and it looks really sleek, but at the same time functional. Two very easy steps up from the cockpit, you get the alfresco deck, which takes a leaf out of the sports motor yacht book. Really nicely protected, so when you're eating out here, whatever the weather, you're going to have protection. You do have opening sunroofs as well. You have this opening hopper window, which gives you the flow through. Also allows you to serve your dinner from the galley. Other features out here, the starboard lounge can convert into a double day bed. To port, you've got a dinette table, folding leaf. I'd be eating lots of meals out here. It's really protected. It's also got some privacy, and it just flows so beautifully through to the rest of the saloon. Here we are in the engine room, which you access from a large hatch in the mezzanine floor. There's also another hatch aft, so if you bring oils or anything down, you can actually access the boat from the main cockpit as well. Surprisingly spacious down here, with really good access to all the things that you're gonna check regularly. The fuel levels, air conditioners, everything. You've got a 13 or 11 kVA gensets, your choice. And what you're looking at here are the Volvo D8 IPS 800s. They generate 600 horsepower each. Moving into the saloon, Riviera has put a U-shaped galley aft and to starboard, so it's really easy to serve meals to the alfresco deck or to the internal dinette. Twin element cooktop, underbench fridges, microwave oven that also has a grill in it. One thing you notice, it has really good storage, overhead lockers, plenty of underbench drawers for your pots and pans and plates, while your glassware has its own recess to port. This is a six-seater lounge surrounding this table. It's really comfortable, great vision. The test boat's off to America, so they've chosen the walnut with a gloss finish. It looks fantastic. Mates really nicely with this subtle sort of brown muted. It feels really passive, really sedate, really comfortable down here and really warm. There's also a 43-inch TV that rises from its own recess. Now a flybridge boat would have a settee here, but you won't be complaining when you see this brilliant helm station. Twin screens, everything that you see on the bigger boats is here, but just on a slightly condensed scale. I really like the fact that this is on the starboard side. Often you get a port side helm, really good vision ahead and astern, 360-degree vision from this station. So as you move downstairs, you find a three-stateroom, two-bathroom layout that's accessed by a really nice light, open and airy atrium. So the trend these days is to have the master cabin amidships where it gets that full beam. But here, the honor goes to the V cabin. And that makes sense on the 465. You still get these hull windows so you get the great view from the bed. Has lots of light coming through. Plenty of storage under bed and also in his and her cupboards. And it just has this lovely quiet feel about it. Also has access to the starboard side ensuite. So really, it's got everything the owners are going to want. The midship section is devoted to the guest cabins, and honestly, they get the best view in the house out these great topside windows. I'm sitting now beneath the helm station. I've still got really comfortable sitting headroom. Feels open and spacious. Also really plush, lovely carpet underfloor, and the beds are actually full-size singles, so tall people will have no problem sleeping in this cabin. Inside the dayhead, you have to keep reminding yourself you're on a sub 50 footer. There's so much space in here. Headroom is fantastic. Again, you can have a view which has a privacy screen. You get the same luxury finishes as you do in the bigger boats on a smaller scale. And you get ensuite access here to the port side guest cabin. So the port side guest cabin has a choice of twin singles, but I'd be going for this queen size double. It sits here beautifully because you've got so much headroom in the cabin, full height to stand up and get in. I think I'd be lying here all day though, looking straight out this hull window. It is huge and you just get the best view of the water. At night, of course, you can add some privacy just by pulling down this blind. I'm with Stephen Milne, the Brand and Communications Director at Riviera. And firstly, congratulations on another fantastic new release.
Thank you, Mark.
Tell us how it fits into the Riviera picture when you have been going big boats lately. I'm loving the fact that you've done a smaller boat.
Well, Riviera has been very, very productive in the last few years. We've launched a range of exceptional boats. Most recently our 78 motor yacht. Now our focus is placing some more energy into that middle part of the market, and the SUV line has also been a great success in recent years and now has six models from 39 to 64 feet. We're seeing people being drawn to SUVs that are perhaps coming out of flybridge boats. They've gone through their boating cycle and they're now wanting a one level boat, but still having that flybridge attitude offshore.
You got this boat ready just in time for the 2022 Sanctuary Cove International Boat Show. What was the reaction at that show?
It was fantastic. There's just so much to like about this in a boat that is so easily handled by a couple, and of course with Riviera's legendary easy to use technology with glass cockpit navigation and with joystick control and digital switching, boating's never been easier or more enjoyable. When you come into the Riviera family, that's what you're being a part of. The evolution of boats to this level of world-class standard, but you're also coming into a family that helps people go boating and keeps them boating. It's all about learning how to use your boat, using it more, and meeting friends that have the same sorts of boats and sharing that common interest.
Yeah, it's a remarkable history and you've had incredible loyalty. Thanks again, Stephen, for having us aboard the 465 SUV today. Really enjoyed the boat and congratulations.
Thank you, Mark.
Doing 1,000 revs at the moment. Speed is around that 7-knot mark. And fuel rate total is 22 litres an hour. It's also really nice and quiet down here at the helm. Bumping it up, you can feel those turbos just starting to kick in now. Off we go. Speed has just jumped up to 15 knots in no time. You just feel that acceleration. It's actually very sporty. The boat weighs under 20 tonnes in dry weight, to which you add 2,500 litres of fuel and 500 litres of water. So I think the 1,200 horsepower is a really good power match. It feels really nice and light on the helm, it steers well. Gotta love IPS drives when it comes to handling. Very responsive. As I say, it's really nice to be driving down at water level. After spending lots of time in flybridge, you feel a little bit more connected with your environment. And as I say, you're also really well connected with your guests. She will do 32 knots, which is really all you want for a long range cruiser. Again, it just feels really soft on the hull, quiet. Right now we're doing 31.5 knots. Fuel usage is 240 litres total. The interesting thing about these planing hulls is even if you go flat out the whole time, you don't really pay for it. Your litres per nautical mile are about the same through the sort of upper performance range. Personally, I like to drive around about that 80% load like we're doing now, getting 25 knots. But if you do have to get somewhere in a hurry, 32 knots for example, you're not going to burn too much fuel. Total range with that 2,500 litres at planing is around 300 nautical miles. If you back that off to displacement speeds, you can do well over 2,000 nautical miles. This is also optioned with the Seakeeper gyro. So again, it turns really flat and level, and it's extremely stable in a seaway. Actually feels like a big boat when you're at the helm. You've got this lovely helm station, all the information well presented in front of you with the gauges. But at the same time, you have that nice sort of nippy performance. It's extremely compact boat. Really notice that mid-range punch. When you jump from 10 to 20 knots, it just gets up, there's no bow rise. It is a real driver's boat. The hull also does a really nice job of throwing the spray well out to the sides. Heading into a 15 knot southerly headwind, we're actually taking no water back aboard. Also creates a nice efficient wake. Rivieras are renowned as long range blue water cruising boats, and the 465 SUV is no different. You can see this heading to the Whitsundays, down to Tassie, anywhere you want to go, and go in comfort and in safety. Right now we're going to head out the Seaway at the Gold Coast just to see how she goes. So you've just had a relaxing day out in the water, and you want to continue that when you get back to the marina. And this has what they call dynamic positioning system. So at the touch of a button, the IPS motors will hold us in station while you get out to prepare your fenders and your ropes. So you might leave your boat at a marina, but you can actually stay connected with it the whole time through this smart app that's available on your phone. It's called Siren Marine. And what it does, it shows you where your boat's positioned, has other great features, so you can monitor your shore power, your batteries, your bilge, your fresh water tank, your fuel tank capacity, all these things at the touch of a button. You can also adjust your switching. So before you get down to the boat, you can turn your water heater on. You can turn different lights on. Again, you don't need to be on the boat to control all these systems. It's a fantastic way of staying in touch with your boat wherever you are. The other thing about Riviera is that they stand behind their boats. This has a 2-year bumper-to-bumper warranty, they call it. It covers everything. There's a 5-year warranty on the Volvo IPS and the glass cockpit. There's also a 7-year hull warranty, which is fantastic to know that you've got that backup. I must say, I'm a massive fan of Riviera's smaller models. The 465 SUV is priced from under $1.8 million, which makes it more tangible, more accessible. Yet you still get all the luxury that you find in the bigger boats and that Riviera experience. There are more details at the end of this video, but for now, I'm Mark Rothfield for Club Marine TV. Thanks for watching.